Welcome back, everybody! I thought I'd wave this time to, you know, save Gibbers the effort. He's been doing a lot recently at the beginnings of episodes. Lots of roaring and waving and bowing. You know what it's like. Oh, well, you don't, unless you're a bloodthirsty hero, which many of you probably are. Last time out, we managed to defeat the area in this boss, which was called the living castaways? The living failures, that was it, yeah. And, what a strange boss fight it was. What weird things. I'm assuming they're sort of what we saw in the room before, the laboratory room, the research hall, but living failures? Like the ones that went wrong but still lived? I don't really know, unless we're going to find something else in this astral clock tower. Key to the astral clock tower. This is what we got for defeating the boss. At the top of the Grand Cathedral, the caretaker of the tower's numerous patients, known to them as only as Lady Maria, made her home behind the giant star interpreting clock. Okay, very nice, very cool. But before we go and do that, I'm going to head back to Ludwig's lantern, and we're going to head back to the cells, the block of cells that shortly followed. Oh. I don't know why I'm surprised by the doll sitting down. She often does that. But we got the key for the underground cell key. Lumenwood. What was the... In the orphanage, there was like Lumen... There was like Lumen Garden or something? No, that's Lumenwood Garden. There was Lumen something. So we need to go back to the underground corpse pile and head back to the cells just following Ludwig's boss area and see if we can open some of them. Okay, so this guy's going to be speaking his rhymes as usual. We remember your rhyme, sir. Let's go in here and speak to him face to face. Oh God, look at the blood! So weird on the wall. Sorry. He's been doing this for a while. You're allowed out now, sir. What did the keys say about this? Hunters are held within the underground cells so that things better left unseen and knowledge better left unknown will quietly fall into darkness. So they've done something that the Healing Church do not approve of. Oh, I can't even talk to him. But you know what I can do? You know what I can do. I can kill him! Let's hope that doesn't have some negative consequences. Ooh! Yamamura hunter hat, the Kaki Hayori, old hunter armbands, and wine hakama. Wow, weird. Let's have a look at some of these things. I put the knight's wig on. Oh, I mean, it's all right. I think it's cool. I think I chose the wrong hair. Lots of these helmets don't go very well with the hair. What else did I get? It had a Japanese name. Yeah, there we go. Kaki Haro. Oh, that's cool. Is it as good as the Grave Executioner? No, it's nowhere near as good. Unfortunately, there was also Old Hunter armbands with ridiculous fire. Oh, they look sick. Ridiculous fire defense. Don't think I'm going to need that anytime soon, though. Yeah. Back to Gascoigne's, and then this one also had quite a Japanesey name, if I recall. A wine hakama. Oh no, I've forgotten which ones I was wearing. Ah, they're like pantaloons. Yeah, they're kind of like pantaloons. They're just like bloomy, tucked in. Oh, look at that, choir trousers. Where did I get the choir trousers from? They're beast. Although not as good as the black church trousers. Oh, I don't know. We'll just stick with these for the time being. They look cool enough. So, these doors will open now. First, I'm just going to get rid of, you know, old stick boy here and his friend Gun Wheelchair Man. Good nicknames, Gibbs. Great nicknames. So, Bert and Ernie are out of the way there. Bloody idiots. We can open this cell, find out what this item is. I'm going to get my Hunter's Torch out, cast out a bit of light. Frenzied Cold Blood 9, always nice. Always useful. I wonder if we can open up that one down there. That's very interesting. Let's crack this one open. Nothing in here. It looks like... Whoa! Oh my goodness! What the hell? Someone wearing the Yahagul black armor set, I think. But they don't want to come out and play. Whoa, what weapon is that? It's like a scythe. It's like a scythe pickaxe. Oh, we can totally cheese it. I could totally cheese it, or I could fight them legit. Oh, is this cheating? This feels kind of cheaty. Oop. Come out here. Why don't you come out? It's like I would go in and tempt them out, but I'm just going to get nailed because I can't block. Okay, here we go. They're coming out now. Rest of the fight is going to be proper. They've also got the repeater pistol. Oh my god, the pike. It sort of turns into a spear-like thing. That's freaking awesome. Is that what we're going to get from this guy? Ow, okay. Okay, give me your spear. Damn it. Why can't I get the... Why can't I land the abyss? Oh my god, he's going for the abyss. I got nailed. Ow, and again. Yeah, you see, when it's a legitimate fight, I don't stand a chance. But through the door I can do. Yeah, you ready for this? No, you were not. Oh, good shot, matey. There we go. The Hulk smash to finish. Give me your weapon, please. The church pick! I actually got it. No way. I was very much expecting not to. Let's see. 14 skill requirement, 9 strength. I can do it. It does look like it's a skill-based weapon. One of the old trick weapons of the Healing Church, a hunting weapon formed from one of the giant picks that appear in old beast tales. The church pick initially serves as a larger sword, but when transformed, functions as an extended war pick. In spite of its origins, it is a highly practical weapon. Let's just have a quick look at the... I know it's not very good lighting in here. There we are. So it's a sort of spear. Oh, it's not... It's got a couple of thrusties, but also sweepies. How does that work? He just seems to pull it shorter, but suddenly it's not facing outwards anymore. I don't know. It's very cool though. Very cool. It's difficult to... It's like a late stage weapon. Unless you can kill Ludwig very early on in a file, it has to be a late stage weapon, doesn't it? That's my problem with it. I don't think I could ever kill Ludwig below a soul level of... Below a level of... I don't know. I struggled. I really, really struggled at 65, 70. I know I didn't know his moveset and stuff, but still. I wonder if he's talking about his own room here. Oh, I can't even get in there. This is not the right key. Alright then, fair enough. So it's back to the giant door where Lady Maria presumably hides behind. Or that's what we've been led to believe by various NPCs. Oh no, there's going to be the tower first. What am I talking about? The clock tower. So I should have enough for another level now. I'm going to stick it into Vitality. So all my levels except Arcane are unrounded. Which I know is displeasing to many people and myself. But I just feel like it because I'm basically sick of this account build. It's become I don't know, it's run away from me very much. Let's see, we can get all sorts in here now, using insight. Bloodstone chunk still costing 20, but I could feasibly get my... Oh, not the saw cleaver, I don't want that. I could get the boom hammer up to plus 9. In fact, I think I'm going to do that. Yeah, let's do it. I'm going to repair... And in terms of blood gems, I don't think I've got any better ones for that I can use. Let's see, 18%, 7.3%. I mean, we could make the Ludwig's Blade bolt damage. Although I don't know what other blood gems I'd put on it that are radials. Attack up. Yeah, I mean, no, it probably wouldn't be as good. I would like to have... Is it worth taking one bolt and one fire and then no regular? I don't know. I have returned to the Lumen Blood Gardens? Lumen Blood. Lumen something Gardens. But it doesn't matter because we're not staying here for much longer. Open this door with the Astral Clock Tower key, which we just got from that last boss fight. And is this... Oh no. It's straight onto another boss fight. Two in a row. Thank God I had a little break. I mean, this is definitely an arena. More bells. Lots of bells. Bells are important for any clock tower, really. That's a very nice face. This is the face that we've seen from very far away, both in the real world and in the DLC, which is very nice sort of continuity. Who is this person here? Maybe they're not going to attack. Maybe we'll just talk to them. Hello. Inspect corpse. Ah, I wonder if this corpse is going to become alive and then explode into something disgusting, just like Vicar Amelia did. I'm gonna have to change my hat to get ready for this. Let's see. Ooh, this is just better all around. But I think it looks shite. The hoods look a bit rubbish. Look at him, all cozy in there. I don't know. Maybe it's because they look better with their actual full armor set. Oh, great. Here we go. Here's a cutscene. She's going to be... Oh, look at the blood on her knee. She's going to explode into some sort of horrific beast. Ooh. Ooh, a kiss. A kiss from Lady Maria.
Should be left well alone.
Oh, no. Okay. Maybe not. You're going to let go of me? Oh, that's kind. Thank you.
Oh, I know very well how the secrets beckon so sweetly. Only an honest death will kill you now.
Oh! That looks like a cool trick weapon. Lady Maria of the Astral Clock Tower. Let's have a look. The comments have said there's one more boss which is impossible and one more which is reasonably easy in comparison to Ludwig. So which one will this be? Who knows? Ouch! I mean, it's not starting off great. Has she got a pistol on her other sword? There we go. Nice. Oh, come on. She didn't turn into a beast like I predicted, so I'm an idiot. Whoa, that was some fast moves there. Is she like a hunter? And why does she describe herself as a corpse? Is she dead? She's got a lot of health. Once more. Not that surprising, to be honest. A lunge. Oh, and the homeward and the bone thing. The old hunter's bone. Okay. Show me your moves, as Captain Falcon would say. Ow! Whoa, that looks like a powerful gun. I think she just sort of whips it out of nowhere. Whoa, nice moves. Oh, no. Oh, good dodge. Okay, just working her out. Just working out the best moves here. That worked not like... Oh. Oh, she holds it sideways. Like some sort of gangster. That was badly timed on my part. Well, no, she's gonna throw it. Oh, no, okay, lunch. What? What is this? Whoa, okay, I should have seen that coming, really. I mean, no excuse there. Another lunge. What? What was that? I'm ready. Oh my god, what's going on? It's like stupid blood moves. Give me my health back. Her weapon's got longer. What is this? There we go. Oh, come on. What's this about? Oh, no, not this again. Whoa. What? How come she can do that? That's not fair. Oh, Jeebus. Thank God she leaves you alone for a bit. I mean, I'm sure she doesn't always, but... Oh, why am I missing that? She's got such a small visceral window. on. Leave out, leave out. Whoa, she's quick. She's quick. Whoa, blood splurge. Ouch! Ouch, that one hurts! What's going on now? What's this? It's new! Oh no, no, that's not new, we've seen that. There's a lot of blood everywhere. It should be noted. That's new. Little fire on the end of that. Oh, why do I keep missing these? This is so embarrassing! Oh, the fire! No, 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 no! Whoa! Holy fuck! Emritas! Amidala, save me! Uh-oh. Oh! Oh, I need to get my viscerals in! Like that, now! Oh, does it give me time? Whoa, fire! Where's the fire come from? Wow! Taste my blade! No, 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 no! This is it, this could be it! One blood vial left! Oh. Where's she going? Yes! Lady Maria, first time! Oh, that was so close! Look at my supplies! Woo! I don't even know if that was hard or gonna be easy or what. I just went for it. Oh, shaking. Look at the blood everywhere. This is where she exploded over here. I mean, imagine if this was a CSI crime scene. They would have a lot to be dealing with. Her chair's gone. Luckily, she no longer needs it. Remember, doll? These flowers that one of the sack-headed people was tending to outside the plip-plop. Mr. Plip-plop, we'll call him. I need to go back and kill Mr. Plip-plop, actually, saying that. But what a fight. What an epic, epic fight. And I really didn't expect to do any of the DLC bosses first time, but that's two in a row. Celestial Dial. I wonder if we're using that. Despicable Secret. No Mercy for Curses. I don't know what that means, but I'm going to rate it up anyway because I'm in a bloody good mood. And we'll see if that goes over here on this altar of sorts. Oh, hang on. I saw it there. Hold up Celestial Dial. Oh, secret! Well, there we go. So, as I was beginning to fight her, I mentioned that commenters said that there was a few more boss fights after Ludwig, one of them being extremely difficult, probably harder than Ludwig, which is difficult to believe, and then one that was, not as hard. Actually, there might have been three more, I can't remember. But there we go, that's one of them. I have no idea which one that was. Is this going to be a cutscene, or are we just going to hold this up? Light's gonna shine on it, is it? Whoa! What's going on? Oh, it opened up! I thought it might do that. I know, I didn't say anything, but I... Raining? Not raining now. Raining? No rain. Sorry, I'll carry on. Where are we now? This better not be another boss fight down here. I mean, it looks like an arena. Looks like it could be. But it also looks like there's a village in the background. Or at least a few buildings. I kind of think there's going to be enemies. Maybe they come out of the water. shipwrecks over there. That looks like an edge. Yeah, let's just not avoid. Let's avoid going for a swim at all costs. Wow, what? This is. I did not expect this. We've got piles of stones like in the Nightmare Frontier. One lead elixir. This is awesome. Very atmospheric. Oh, what's that? Something coming towards me from the town. Madman's knowledge. Please, Bergenworth. I can't target him, so I'm gonna say he's someone you can talk to. Wow, okay. Hello. Oh! Look at his face!
Atonement lay the curse of blood upon them and their children. And their children's children forevermore. Each wretched birth. Plunge each child into a lifetime of misery.
He's a bit phlegmy. I'd say he's also a little bit twisted by something. A little bit made bitter. Oh no, damn it, I missed something that was new.
Atonement for the wretches lay the curse of blood.
I think he says swap between the two, is he?
Mercy. The poor wizened child. Let the pungence of castle cling like a mother's devotion.
I think Mikalash mentioned the cause numerous times. Whoa, that was close. Almost fell in. I wonder where he's going. Yeah, sorry, look at the windows up this wall. It's like, it looks like a natural cliff face, but there are windows built into it, which is obviously perfectly plausible. This is a little bit like when you arrive at the Iron Keep in Dark Souls 2, and you're like, hang on, I just left an area full of swamp with no, like, with no upwards direction in the tower, but I left it going upwards and then found this. However, I kind of feel like it's slightly more justified because this is obviously a nightmare, a dream world. Non-realistic and illusionary, and therefore... Oops, Spectre. Okay, something is here that can kill you. Oh, the fishing hamlet! How lovely! Ooh, look at this sea creature. I think we saw one of these in the Chalice Dungeons. The fishing hamlet, okay. Ah, someone's left a body up there just to dry out. Not gonna happen in this rainy weather. Friend is effective, but the sky and the cosmos are one. Oh, is that another friend? Whoa. A fishing pike. I can't believe I missed so many viscerals on Lady Maria. You know, there's probably stuff I could go back to the research hall and do now that Lady Maria's dead, I imagine. And I've just remembered I have no supplies. Gonna have to be quite careful. This looks amazing. Look at all the... I live right by the sea, so... I'm used to... I mean, obviously not buildings being covered in this, but certainly sort of old bits of wood being covered in these sort of shingly type things. Shingles, is that right? I don't know if that's right. What's this on the floor? Is that a body? With talons. Interesting. this is weird. I mean, not that the DLC hasn't been already. And you can hear people murmuring inside the houses, I think. Why would anybody choose to live here? It's mostly swamped. Whoop, okay. Even the residents are covered in shingles. Oh, and they're dropping stuff. Oh, thank you. Thank you. Much needed supplies. Just checking for... I wonder if there's going to be any orange lanterns. Is this person... Hello? Can I talk to you? You don't seem to be that much of a threat. Oh, okay, now you're a threat. You are officially a threat, and I have license to steal your life. Oh, or you can just go down there. That's all right as well, actually. What's this? It's just a light. Fish! Fish in a barrel! Two blood vials. He was slightly more agile than the other ones. And there's also these piles of... Whoop, whoop! What was that? There's also these piles of... Oh, it's... Walking on this, is it? No. I don't know what that noise is. Slightly odd. Somebody's having a very good time upstairs, maybe. Let's see. Tempering gem 6. Physical attack up 9.1%. Thrust attack up 10.9%. Okay. That's almost 20%, including the thrust. If you want to include the thrust. I mean, I guess it's alright. I still, to this point, and I've played... Almost like 50, 60 hours of this game now. I still don't understand why physical attack has a value, but blunt and thrust attack also have values, like damage values. Is it that you can have a weapon, say the Ludwig sword, and only some attacks are thrust, and therefore only the thrust value is used sometimes? Or they get added together? Or it's always applied? Like, a weapon is either considered blunt or thrust plus physical? I really, really don't understand it. And it's kind of annoying because it means I feel bad using thrust and blunt type gems. Because I'm worried they won't get... What the hell? What the hell was that? I feel like this is going to be a reoccurring thing, yeah? Yeah. Okay. It's like the skulls that... Oh, just takes one hit to kill, though. That's alright. It's like the skulls that Logarius fires at you. Laird Elixir. Whoa! Whoa! No way! What's up with his face? Oh, God. That was... Whoa, that's a grab. Uh-oh. What the hell is this? I mean, the little villagers were weird enough, but these big guys, they are odd. What's up with this? Everyone's, like, suddenly it's gone from a relatively succinct concept of kind of gruesome beasts. Whoa! I got hit by it. Suddenly there's fishmen. It's like mermen. Weird. I don't know. I guess, actually saying that, quite a lot of the enemies in this game have been based on things from Japanese mythology and fairy tales and things like that. So this is probably just more of the same. Especially seeing as Japan is... It's very coastal. It's got a big fishing industry, so... There's obviously a lot of Thank you very much for that, my good sir. He's actually throwing bombs. They are cartoon style, round black with a fuse bombs, which I quite like. That do a lot of damage, actually. Four boilers. What's the scream? Oh, ow, ouch. How very rude. I didn't even see that coming. I just heard the scream. Let's see. This direction is not one that I've been in. Can you destroy these boats? I don't imagine so. No. Okay. Curiosity has been satisfied. Oh, it's a bomb. Has he got bombs on his belt? He's got bombs on his belt. These are the things that... These explode, I think. In fact, there was a bunch of them over here, but I'm not sure why. Are these... Five blood vials? Was that from a... That was just from a normal person. That's cool. I'm almost up to full blood bars. That's crazy. I am. There it is. Although I am going to use one. Just for a little security. And now we could go upstairs and meet the guy chucking bombs. He's still chucking bombs. Hasn't learned his lesson. Now he's jumped out. And now he's paid the price. A couple of oil urns. Didn't drop any of his homemade... Well, I don't even know if they're homemade. They might be bulk bought. They might be corporate bombs. Industrialized bomb making. Got an item over here. Odd fire damp blood gem. That is a long ass name. And I should have gone from the bottom because it's a triangle. Fire attack plus 27 and up 8.1%. That's crazy. That's amazing. I don't think I've... Oops. No. The boom hammer doesn't have a triangle slot in it. Maybe if I get the uncanny boom hammer or the lost boom hammer, it will have that. It will have a triangle instead of a crescent shape. That would be awesome. I think there's something I missed over here because there was a set of stairs with an item on it coming down in this building here. So I need to find out how to get up there. And I'm wondering if it's something I've missed. Oh, there's a ladder. Is that ladder going to come down? Maybe. What? Is that... Okay, I'm going to say that that's a shortcut in the future, and that's how we're going to get to the item I'm trying to get to. So for the time being, I will leave it alone. And hopefully we haven't missed out on anything too important. Oh, for God's sake. I forgot about you. You're chucking harpoons. Oh, they make a blob. Ooh, fish dog! Because obviously they had to have some sort of dog, didn't they? I bet we'll be finding fish crows next. Ooh! Ow, did that just stun me? Weird bubbly noised fish dogs. Whoa, where are they all coming from? Ooh! Taste this! My goodness, they're not that hard, to be fair. I don't know whether it's just because I'm used to the... Very, very used to the game by now or whatever, but they're pretty easy. As far as enemies go, no one I can speak to yet. We haven't found any NPCs other than the one at the very beginning of this area. The fishing, what? It's such a different vibe from the rest of the DLC. Nothing like that looks particularly secret. Whoa, another one of those. Whoa, extreme dodging skills there. Great ones, wisdom. Oh no, a big one. And he's got a weapon this time. Oh, I actually got hit by one. Oh, and I got hit by him. Ow! No! Ooh! Ah ha ha! Oh no! He's getting me with his anchor! Everything's sailing themed! Or fish, at least. Maybe the boom hammer will be effective? Maybe not, I don't know. I think the other weapon's doing better. The weapon's cool. Oh, nearly dead. Mad combos for days. Okay, I've got to start. I've got to get. What the hell is this attack? Oh, this enemy's cool though. He's very cool. I'm using all my well-earned blood vials. Look at the thrashing. Hopefully this will do it. There we go, nice. 4 blood bars, what he gave me last time. Oh, a warm, damp blood gem. I mean, that's all right. Slightly better one for scaling, but I don't really use it. I don't know anyone. I mean, when would you use it? When would you use blood scaling gems on weapons? Unless you're using, like, the cannon or something. What's this? This is... Is this how you get that item over there? Where even am I now? Ah, here we are. Through this little gap here. This looks right. Where are you, item? Here we are. Bloodstone charm. Cool, right then. Cool. I wonder what the lowest level someone has done the DLC on is, because it's mighty difficult. Oh, these are the windows we could see in the walls as we were entering the area, speaking to Mr. Crazy Dude. Oh, the moon, ominous and present. And this is the next area, it seems, of this fishing village. Oh god, what is that? Is that a boss? That giant white thing? Well, I'm afraid we'll have to wait to find out, because this is the end of this particular episode. Episode 47? I really thought this series would be less than 50, but it's definitely not going to be. Probably not more than 60, though, I would say. I don't know. We'll just have to see how stuck I get on various different bosses. But if there's only 2 left in the DLC, which is what I'm thinking, and 2 left in the actual game... Then there's not that much content more to see. So, exciting stuff. I mean, not if you're a fan of this playthrough, which I personally am. I'm not sure if there are many others. Well, I mean, you've been perfectly vocal, the ones that you are. And I appreciate you continuing to view... Continuing! I appreciate the continuing support and views. It's very, very much appreciated. As I've already said. Fuck! Going round and round in circles. There isn't much more to say apart from... Thank you very much for watching. This DLC is really heating up, if it hasn't done so already. And I will see you in the next part. I've been OC Gibbs. Thank you much for watching. Goodbye.